It's the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer.
Happy holidays from your friends at Newmark Credit Union, where you are family. Good morning. It's time for Money Talk, brought to you by Newmark Credit Union. Today, don't get wrapped into Christmas. That's W-R-A-P-P-E-D, into Christmas. And it's brought to you, of course, by Newmark Credit Union. If you have a topic for the new year for Money Talk, you can email it to moneytalk@newmarkcu.org. We'd love to hear from you. Our friends from Newmark will be back with us in January for more Money Talk shows. Until then, Newmark Credit Union would like to wish you and your family a joyous holiday season and a happy new year. I'd like to welcome into our WJOL studios the marketing specialist for Newmark. It's Leah Avery. Hi, Leah. How are you?
Hi, I'm good. How are you?
Good. Thanks for coming in. And also we have Christy Bullock. She's a call center representative. Hi, Christy.
Hi, how are you?
I'm awesome. Thank you very much. And Laura Vesey is a mortgage loan processor, and we believe she is en route. Or en route.
I hope so.
I hope so. If not, it won't be so holly jolly of a Christmas for her, because we're going to have to tease her and make fun of her publicly, right?
For sure.
You're dang right. All right, so what we thought we'd do today is don't get wrapped in Christmas. We have these folks here from Newmark Credit Union, these wonderful people, to share with us some of their traditions and tips to enjoy the holiday season, because we all get wrapped up in our own little traditions. And there's some really cool things that other people do out there, and we might give you some ideas on how to maybe spruce up your holidays just a little bit. Because holidays, no pun intended, they're kind of like Groundhog Day. It's every year's kind of the same, right?
Yeah, essentially, I think so.
Yeah, which isn't always a bad thing, no?
Not at all.
Nope, not at all. Because we get used to it, and that's what Christmas is all about, is kind of doing those same things over and over and over. So what we're going to do here today also, we're going to give you some great Christmas talking ideas and things like that. But we're also going to give away a $25 Visa gift card, compliments of Newmark Credit Union. You can use them anywhere Visa is accepted. They even make a great gift. I know I need to go out and buy one today, so I wish I was eligible, because I would try to call in and win. And you can purchase your Visa gift card at the nearest Newmark location near you. And how are we going to give that away? Well, at the end of the program, we're going to ask you a question, something that you've heard during Money Talk, and we'll ask you to be the first caller at 254-7300. And if you are, you will win that $25 Visa gift card. But before we talk a little bit about Christmas, let's talk a little bit about yourself. Christy, we'll start with you. Tell everybody a little bit about you and how long you've been with Newmark.
Okay, so my name is Christy, and I have been with Newmark for 5 years. I am a mom of two with a 6-year-old and an almost 2-year-old.
Oh, boy.
Yes. And then I'm also a cheer coach for the Tri-City Wolverines.
Which are, what are the Tri-City Wolverines?
They are a cheer and football. It's a nonprofit organization.
All right.
So, yes, come join our team.
And that's out of where?
Plainfield.
Out of Plainfield. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, cool. So you're the call, so what do you do in the call center then? What's your normal day look like, or is there not a normal day?
Every day is a different day. We answer phones, and then we just transfer them out to the different departments when they needed to be transferred out.
And you guys are probably pretty busy, right?
Yeah. Yeah. We're very busy.
Absolutely. So, no doubt. All right, Leah, what about you? How long have you been with Newmark?
About 6 months, so I'm a baby.
Newbie.
Here. I'm a newbie. Yes, yes, yes.
All right, so what brought you to Newmark? I know you're, you know, obviously the job, but what was it about the, like, because, you know, people walk into job interviews all the time, and then they walk out going, you know what, I'm not working there.
So true. I think it was just the culture, like meeting everyone. I had worked with everyone previously when I was in school. I did a little bit of freelance for Newmark, so really loved everyone, and when I came in, everyone was just so nice. I love that we do things with the community, so... Yep. It was just like a perfect fit for me, because I'm such a community-orientated person as well.
Where did you do an internship then, or
it wasn't? It wasn't really an internship. Okay. It was kind of like they had a guy who was interning there, and they needed some video editing done, and he lived next door to me at school. In school, so nice. He knocked on my door and asked me, "Hey, Newmark needs this. Can you help me out?" And I was like, "Sure." And then.
The rest is history. Are you from Joliet originally?
No, from Chicago.
Chicago, okay. Mm-hmm. And what school did you go to?
I went to Gwendolyn Brooks.
Okay, all right. Brooks, yep. And then college?
College, I went to Prairie State, where I'm a basketball coach there now.
Oh.
Assistant for women's, yeah. So, like, when I said, like, the community aspect drew me in, like, that's what I do.
Yeah, we should talk hoop. We should do a whole nother show on hoop, because that's my favorite thing in the world.
And then I went to St. Francis, so... Yeah. Yeah. I'm familiar with the area.
All right. Well, good. What about you, Christy? Where were you born and raised?
I was born and raised in Bolingbrook, Illinois.
All right.
I grew up in Shanahan. I went to Minooka High School.
Where do you live now?
In Plainfield.
In Plainfield now. Okay. Mm-hmm. Why'd you leave Shanahan? Shanahan's a great place.
Just kind of ventured out this way.
I live in Shanahan, so I'm like, why'd you leave Shanahan? We need people like you
down
there.
My parents still live there.
Well, good. Tell them I said hi.
I will.
Would you tell them Mr. Slocum said hi? Absolutely so. All right, so let's get into this here. If you had to pick one holiday memory, mm-hmm. we'll start with you, Christy. What would that be?
Okay, so I have actually a few.
Oh,
but the one that really sticks out for me is that one year my husband actually proposed to me at Navy Pier in a snow globe in front of everybody.
Did you kill him? He was okay? No.
Yes.
So what do you mean? So they have a life-size snow globe down there?
Mm-hmm. A life-size snow globe. And then we walked in and he was like picking up the snow. I'm like, what are you doing? Just like stand up. And he's like, no, I'm proposing to you. I'm like, you're what? What? And so like everybody saw it, and there's people videoing it.
Could they hear him? And they hear both of you? Or is it?
No. When they saw that he was on the knee, one person in the background's like, oh, he's proposing.
That's awesome. And you obviously said yes.
Yes.
2 kids later, you said yes.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Oh, so what date was that on? Was that like in early December?
You're asking me?
Early December. I don't remember the date that I proposed either. So you're good. Don't worry about that. You better remember your wedding day.
I do.
Which is your anniversary. Okay.
Yes.
We'll let it slide on that. Well, that's kind of cool.
Mm-hmm.
That is a great memory. Oh, my gosh.
Mm-hmm.
He said probably you're not going to get one of these every Christmas now, pointing to your ring, right?
No, he did good. He did good.
I was going to say he sure did. What about you, Leah?
I'm going to go a little bit more towards like family. I remember the first time my grandmother changed our tree. So growing up, we never had a traditional Christmas tree. It was a big plant.
A plant?
A big plant. So we would put our presents under a big plant. And I remember one year she didn't have time to get one. So we just used the plant and we had kept using it ever since.
That's awesome.
So that's my favorite memory.
Does that plant still live?
Oh, no, that plant's long gone.
That plant's long gone?
Yeah.
So what it was, it wasn't as cheesy as these fake plants that we have in here, was it?
No, it wasn't as cheesy.
Okay.
But pretty cheesy. But it was okay because it was my grandma and I love her.
So you purposely kept that then?
Purposely, yep.
That's awesome. Yep. That's good. That is really, really good. All right, so what are some of the things that you do now? Now, you know, you're out of school and, you know, mm-hmm. you're just getting started on your journey and your path and everything like that. What are some of the things that you like to do in terms of making memories with your family during the holiday season, Lou?
Well, one thing that I do, and I'm kind of a firebug, and I have, like, small kids in the family. So one thing that we do is we signal Santa to let him know that we're ready.
Ah.
Uh-huh. So I have a balcony, and I'll go out, and I'll get fireworks, and I'll just point them up to the sky, and I'll just release the fireworks into the air. The kids are like looking through the windows like, they're doing it. And we're letting Santa know, come on, we're ready. And then we'll hide them in the room. We'll play some like Christmas music, you
sure.
know, the Santa on the roof type music mm-hmm. and rest is history.
And then all the presents, they come back out and all the presents
and all
are
the
there.
Presents are there.
That's pretty cool. I've never
yeah.
heard of that before. That's different. All right. Top that, Christy.
I can't. That was really good.
That was good.
That was
you could
really
adopt
good.
That, something like that.
Right. We just usually do the Elf on the Shelf. I know a lot of you guys do the Elf on the Shelf. We also do a ugly pajamas. On Christmas Eve, what we do is that we have a name that we do through Greg Bag throughout the year. Mm-hmm. And then after that, you buy the person the ugliest pajamas, and they have to wear them on Christmas Eve to open up the Christmas presents.
That's good.
Mm-hmm.
That's
so
a good
one.
That's
a lot of fun.
That is a lot of fun. Where do you find ugly pajamas?
Oh, you can find them.
They're all over the place?
They're everywhere.
Kind of like ugly sweaters now, right?
Yes, but they're pajamas.
Did you guys see the guy in the hallway that had the Mickey Mouse Christmas sweater on?
No way.
Yeah. Find him when you leave. It's somebody said, where'd you get that? He goes, I got it at Kohl's. Laura Vesey is here. She's the mortgage loan processor. Hi, Laura.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm well. How are you?
Good
doing?
To see you. Nice to see you. You're lucky you made it because we were very close to publicly humiliating you. Because we like to have 3 of you in here, not just 2. So, Laurie, tell everybody how long you've been with Newmark Credit Union.
I've been with Newmark for about 6 months now.
Six? Well, you guys, all right. Well, you've been here a little bit longer, but Yeah, you guys are relatively new. And Lori, what was it that brought you to Newmark? Was obviously you're a mortgage loan processor, but where were you before and what brought you to Newmark?
I'm actually the operations manager, and previously I was with a company called Home Point.
Ah.
I've been doing mortgages for over 35 years.
35 years?
Yeah.
You started young, huh?
I did.
Yeah.
I think I was 12 when I started. What brought me to Newmark was the new adventure. I've always worked out of town, and now I'm literally in my backyard. So,
big deal. Yeah.
This is my first time working with a credit union, and I've learned so much, and it's just been such an exciting ride. So I'm just looking forward to the next 20 years with Newmark.
The next 20 years, so you'll retire then at 67, right? If you started at 12, 55 years in, you're good, right?
I don't think I'll ever retire. I'll be doing mortgages until the day I go home.
Well, it's a good line of work, especially in this area, too. There's a lot of business, no doubt. All right, ladies, well, Christmas obviously is a big time for kids, and we'll start with you, Christy, because you have two little ones. What are some of the special things you do with your kids or the children in your family?
Like I said previously, the Elf on the Shelf is one of the big things that we do.
Right.
My daughter loves waking up at all hours to go find the elves, and I'm like, Peyton, you need to, you know, go back to sleep. They haven't moved yet. It's like 3:30 in the morning. Haven't moved them.
3:30?
Yeah, she wakes up.
Oh,
well, both my kids don't sleep through the night, so we're up. All hours of the night.
Isn't that terrible? Because parents will be up late for one reason or another. We won't say why in case any little kids are listening right now. But, you know, you get to bed around 2 or 2:30, and it's 5:30 in the morning, and you get in the tug at the comforter, right?
Yeah. Well, my kids sleep in the bedroom with us, so.
Okay.
My little one, he's always sick. He has eczema, so he's always itching. So I think that what wakes him up, too. So.
Yeah. All right, what about you? You talked about what you do with the little ones. Anything else that you do as Leah, as far as the little kids go?
Pretty much the only other thing is, like, just letting them put the tree up, just kind of sitting back and letting them actually figure it out and match the colors to the letters and letting them argue with each other. And
match the color to the letters. Okay.
Yeah, because, right. You know, when you're putting it together.
Exactly.
Like, you know your colors, you know your letters, so I know you can do it. So go forth and do it.
That's good. So, That's good. Lori, what about you? Or what are some of the things you did with your kids when they were little?
Well, we spent every Christmas Eve with my mom, with my side of the family.
Mm-hmm.
We used to travel from my husband's side to my side, and we decided, I think my son was about 6 years old, that we were no longer traveling. So whatever we did, we do it on Christmas Eve. So now we have a big family dinner. We wear the ugly sweaters or we wear pajamas. And then on Christmas Day, we stay home and just share time with our family. What we do is put cookies out for Santa.
Okay.
The kids love that. And now I have grandbabies, and they're just like, Grandma, are we baking cookies today? Is today the day? I'm like, not yet. You still got 25 more days. So we bake cookies on Christmas Eve once we come back from dinner with my family. And we wake up. The kids probably get up about 4:30, 5 o'clock. Santa's eating all the cookies, and we open gifts, and we just start with the little mimosas for brunch and enjoy our family.
Very good. Very, very good. I remember, you know, talking about your kids getting up early. I remember one year we made them not get up till 7. We said, if you come downstairs before 7, those toys might just disappear when you first lay your eyes on. We needed some sleep.
Mm-hmm. That's a good one.
Try that.
We'll try it.
It works. It works very, very well. All right. Now this, you know, we bring in the credit union part of this. So we go from family traditions to how to stay within a budget during the holidays. Who's got some ideas?
Me. So Blaine, my son, he is 23 years old. I started a Christmas club 24 years ago, and I still do a Christmas club account. And that was one of the best things that I could possibly do. First, it keeps me in line with how much money I want to spend every year. And then it keeps me in line with not using my credit cards, you know, for additional gifts and stuff. If it's outside of the budget, no one gets it. But this year we went to a 3 present per person. I did anyway. My husband doesn't know, but, you know, because I think, and my kids have always decided to share their gifts. I think that they give their toys away every year so that they can get more toys and now bigger things. But I think it's really important that you set a budget. and you live within that budget.
Sure.
And that will always help you. So that in January, you're not looking at all these bills saying, oh, my God, how am I going to pay this credit card debt?
Can we have money taken out of our paychecks to go into a Christmas Club account?
Yes.
Yes.
Will you just do that? Okay. Mm-hmm.
And to add on to hers with the Christmas Club, which is nice, is that you can open it anytime throughout the year.
Okay.
And then on October 1st, it gets transferred into your savings account, whatever you put in there. Now, if you take it out of our like Christmas Club, there is a small little fee for it. So it just actually helps budget better so that, you know, you're not touching that.
Mm-hmm.
So you could put your paycheck in there. You could put whatever you want in there anytime. So that's a good way.
Yeah, absolutely. So what's the Goal Savers account?
So the Gold Savers account, what it is that you have to open it up with $250 to open up the Gold Saver, and it's kind of more like a savings account as well.
Okay.
So then you would just, you know, deposit money into the account, and then once per quarter you are able to withdraw out of the account without any fee, and then if you have to, again, it's a $20 fee. So this is also another way to budget for Christmas time.
Okay. All right. What about loans around the holidays? Do you have holiday loans?
Yes, we also have holiday loans. Those are going on right now. This is great for, you know, that extra cash. We also have credit cards going on, too, right now. That's very good. That's at a zero interest rate for the first 20 billing cycles.
Wow.
So that's really good, too.
That's really good. Really, really, really good. All right, so we talked a little bit about traditions, talked about some of the good deals. Talk about taking care of ourselves, because a lot of people get sick around the holidays because you're running here, you're running there, you're trying to have this perfect Christmas, the perfect holidays, be the perfect daughter-in-law, the perfect husband, the perfect wife, whatever. Let's get some tips here. Lori, let's start with you. How do you take care of yourself other than those mimosas around the holiday season?
I'm a firm believer in taking time. I love massages. I get my nails done. I get my feet done.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a swimmer. So, you know, when I really want to relax and get away from the family, I go to the Y where I walk laps and just swim. So it is extremely important, especially as we get older. It's extremely important to take time for yourself.
Yeah, no doubt. Christy, what about you? It's tough for you because you got the two little ones always at you, but what do you do to try to get away and chill just a little bit?
It's very hard to say because we're always on the go and we're always doing something. My kids, from the time they wake up to the time they go to bed, they're nonstop. So just, you know, trying to relax and trying to get sleep, which I don't get sleep, but
we
just try to do the best. I mean, we do smoothies at night just to get some fruit in and vitamin C, but it's nice to try to take 5 minutes to yourself.
But Yeah. Well, good luck with that for the next 10, 12 years or so. Leah, what about you? What do you do to kind of just take a step away from it all?
Pretty much. I am a big scheduler, so I will schedule breaks for myself. I will definitely schedule shop time, like if I want to go out and get gifts, like know where I'm going to go, have routes already set up. And I am a sleeper, so I will for sure will get my rest, so I make sure that I get
too,
that
man.
Done too.
Yeah. I'm a world-class sleeper.
Yeah, professional.
Yeah. You got it. Exactly right. Now, you have the little ones. Leah, you don't have any kids yet. Lori, you, as you mentioned, your kids are a little bit older, so if you're sitting around on break or whatever talking to Christy or other parents out there that have little ones, what advice would you give them around the holidays to enjoy it a little bit more with their kids?
Definitely getting yourself a babysitter and getting time away for Christy, you and your husband. My husband and I have been married for almost 25 years. We still have date night.
Nice.
And I have grandkids now. I have 4 grandkids. So, you know, the kids are always looking for grandma to babysit. And sometimes you just have to say, no, it's time for me and my husband. So I think it's important, like you said, scheduling, you know, put something on the calendar that says this day is for me, either me by myself or me and my husband. But it's really important that, you know, you schedule some time to just be able to do you.
No doubt about that. No doubt. All right. Did you listen to that, Christy?
I did.
You're good.
I
All did. Right. Date night.
So you're babysitting, right?
I'll babysit. I love babysitting.
I got two.
They'll just fit right in with my grandbabies.
Ladies, thanks for coming in today. I hope you guys enjoy the week. And what's important is just hanging out with the fam, I think, at the end of the day.
Yes. Yes,
that's the big thing.
Making memories.
You got it. You're right. Leah Avery and Lori VC and Christy Bullock, thank you, ladies, for coming in. Have a very happy holidays. We appreciate you stopping by today.
Thank you.
You got it. Hey, we have a $25 Visa gift card, compliments of Newmark Credit Union. You can use them anywhere Visa is accepted. They make a great gift. Purchase your Visa gift card at Newmark's location nearest you. They got a bunch of them around the area. All right. What is Lori's drink of choice on Christmas morning? 815-254-7300 is the phone number. 815-254-7300. I second it, by the way. What is Lori's drink of choice early on Christmas morning? Okay, maybe not that early. It's noon somewhere, right, Lori?
There you go.
You're dang right it is. First correct caller gets a $25 Visa gift card to Newmark Credit Union. And don't forget, folks, if you have a topic for Money Talk, you can email it to moneytalk@newmarkcu.org. They'd love to hear from you. Our friends from Newmark will be back with us in January for more Money Talk shows. Until then, Newmark Credit Union would like to wish you and your family a joyous holiday season and a happy new year.
It's the happiest season of all.